Hello student, welcome in today's session. Today we are going to learn about the some blood disorders or the heart disorders or the disorders related with the circulatory system. There are many disorders or dysfunctioning of the heart. One of them, it is hypertension or high blood pressure, or it may be called as high BP. You know that our normal blood pressure, it is 120 about 80 mm of Hg, and it is the ratio of systolic blood pressure to the diastolic blood pressure. What do you mean by blood pressure? That is the ratio of systolic and diastolic blood pressure. What is systolic blood pressure? It is the blood pressure or the pressure exerted by the blood on the wall of artery during the ventricular contraction. During ventricular contraction, 120 mm of Hg is the pressure exerted by blood on the wall of artery. And what is diastolic blood pressure? It is the pressure exerted by the blood on the wall of artery during the ventricular relaxation. That is called diastolic blood pressure. Diastole means relaxation of ventricles, and systole means the contraction of ventricles. And this ratio of blood pressure during the systole and diastole, that ratio, it is nothing but the blood pressure, and it is 120 to 80 mm of Hg. That systolic blood pressure is 120 and diastolic blood pressure is 80 mm of Hg, and it is measured by sphygmomanometer in terms of a height of a mercury column. When that blood pressure rises above the normal level, that condition of a heart, that condition of a blood, it is nothing but the hypertension. Hypertension, याचा मराठीत अर्थ खूप टेन्शन घेणे असा होत नाही, पण खूप टेन्शन घेतल्यामुळे ब्लड प्रेशर हाय होऊ शकतं हे वाक्य तितकंच खरं आहे. दॅट हायपरटेन्शन मीन्स इट इज ॲबनॉर्मल राईज इन बी पी अबो नॉर्मल. ॲबनॉर्मल मीन्स अबो द नॉर्मल. इट इज ॲबनॉर्मल राईज इन ब्लड प्रेशर. वॉट इज ॲबनॉर्मल राईज? ॲबनॉर्मल ग्रोथ इन अ बी पी. That normal BP is 120 about 80 mm of Hg, and you know that when a systolic blood pressure, it is rises above the 120. If it is go to the 140, above 140, then it is a high systolic blood pressure. And diastolic blood pressure, when it is go above the 80, that is above 90, it is called as a high BP, high diastolic pressure. When the total ratio is rises by 10 or 20, their difference is 120 about 80, their difference is 40 mm of Hg. If the differences get increases, means the systolic blood pressure goes up to the 140 or above 140, diastolic blood pressure goes up to the 90 or above 90, and that is called as a high blood pressure. This high blood pressure ratio, it is given by 140 about 90 mm of Hg. That hypertension, it is defined as abnormal rise in the blood pressure above normal, that is called as a high BP or hypertension. The normal blood pressure is 120 to 80 mm of Hg, and if that blood pressure rises up to the 140 to 90 mm of Hg, then it is called as a hypertension. And the dangerous risk level, it is the range given by 180 about 120 mm of Hg. The systolic blood pressure rises up to 180 and diastolic blood pressure rises up to 120. That ratio is the end level of hypertension. At that level, the blood vessels may rupture, brain blood vessels may rupture, it results into brain hemorrhage. Many things happen with the heart and the main vital organs of the body. Then a continuous rise in the blood pressure called as high BP. Again, it can be defined as, what is one definition of a hypertension? It is the abnormal rise or abnormal growth in a normal BP. When normal BP goes up to the abnormal level, it is coinciding its normal BP level, it limits its normal BP level, then it is called as a hypertension. And that abnormal limit is 140 to 90 mm of Hg. It exceeds above the 120, it exceeds above the ATMM of age. And again, it can be defined in another way, that is a continuous rise in the arterial blood pressure. A continuous rise in arterial blood pressure, it is also called as high BP. That when blood exerts a pressure on the wall of artery, that artery also exerts a pressure on that blood. And that is called as a peripheral resistance. When a continuous rise in the arterial blood pressure, artery's blood pressure, when it is continuously go on increases, then it is called as a high blood pressure, or it is also called as a hypertension. Then when there is a hypertension, what happens with the main vital organ? It harms to the three organs, mainly heart, brain and kidneys. When there is a hypertension, these three organs get harmed very seriously. That when there is a high BP or high blood pressure, that means a heart experiences a overloading of work, overworking of heart. At that time, it results into a continuous progressive weakening of a cardiac muscles takes place. And in that progressive weakening, there is a low oxygen supply to the heart. And in that condition, that heart suffer from that hypoxia. Heart suffer from coronary artery disease, that main artery which supplies the oxygenated blood to heart, that is the coronary artery which present on the interventricular septum. And if that artery have any problem due to the high BP, it having a blockages. And it is a main disease of heart again, that is the CAD, coronary artery disease, or also known as the atherosclerosis. That heart damaged in that way, that it having the low oxygen supply, it efficiency of cardiac muscle get decreases. Then second way, that how brain affected by the hypertension, that brain having the minute blood vessels which having the blood supply by the heart. And it is the main vital organ of the body, therefore it needed the continuous supply of oxygen. And when it is affected by the high BP, it result into the internal bleeding and the bursting of that blood vessel, which result into the brain hemorrhage, brain hemorrhage in another way it is called as. Then how kidney get affected? That when heart gets the low blood supply and it automatically gets the low oxygen, cardiac muscles get weakened progressively, then there is a low blood supply to the kidney also, and the renal blood vessels get damages. There is a renal damage takes place, kidney get damaged due to the low blood supply, low oxygen supply, and it result into the nephritis. Nephritis means inflammation of a nephron, inflammation of the minute the tube like structure which are for the urine formation, that is called as nephron. And inflammation of nephron, it is called as nephritis. Nephritis and renal damage, that is the damage to kidney, these are the effects of hypertension on the kidney. That when there is a hypertension, what happens exactly? Heart uses more energy to pump the blood. When there is a high BP, heart uses more energy. It exerts more pressure on the cardiac muscles. From the SA node, from the vagus nerve, from the AV node, a strong way of contraction is passes. And that when heart using more energy to pump the blood, it result into a slight to heavy pain in the cardiac muscles, and that is called as angina pectoris. One of the again disease in our syllabus, that is the angina pectoris. What is angina pectoris? A strong pain or severe pain or mild to severe pain in the cardiac muscles during the inhalation and exhalation. That pain may vary from place to place. It is again lengthened to our lower jaw. It is lengthened to our ear and the lower cheek area. It lengthened to the neck. It is spread towards the left hand, left lower arm, then the muscles and the nerves of the left ear, left behind cheek area, and the neck, shoulder, left arm and the back area of the left side. That pain in that area, it is due to the hypertension. and that severe pain in the cardiac muscles during the inhalation, that is called as angina pectoris. छातीमध्ये कळ येणं ह्याला आपण अँजायना पेक्टोरिस म्हणतो. ती कळ जर चालताना सुद्धा कंटिन्यू होत असेल तर इट इज द सिव्हिअर केस ऑफ अँजायना पेक्टोरिस. इट मे रिझल्ट इन टू द मायोकार्डियल इन्फ्रॅक्शन, विट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज हार्ट अटॅक, ज्याला आपण अटॅक येणं असं म्हणतो. मीन्स इफ देर इज अ कंटिन्युअस बी पी प्रॉब्लेम्स, ब्लड प्रेशर प्रॉब्लेम्स इन दॅट पर्सन, दॅट पर्सन बिकम अ पेशंट, दॅट पेशंट हॅविंग दॅट लो ऑक्सिजन सप्लाय टू द हार्ट, प्रोग्रेसिव्ह विकनिंग ऑफ मसल्स ऑफ अ हार्ट, दॅट इज द प्रोग्रेसिव्ह विकनिंग ऑफ कार्डियक मसल्स, देअर फॉर हार्ट गेट वीकंड अँड वीकंड. ठीक आहे. देन वेन हार्ट हॅविंग हायपरटेन्शन, इट युजेस मोर एनर्जी टू पंप द ब्लड, द पंपिंग ॲक्शन गेट इन्क्रीजेस अँड इट फील्स मोर प्रेशर, अँड ड्यू टू दॅट प्रेशर इट हॅविंग अ सिव्हिअर पेन, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ पेन इन कार्डियक muscles or pain in a coronary artery, that is called as angina pectoris. Coronary artery, it is the main artery to the heart which supplies the pure blood to the heart, oxygenated blood to heart, and more problems experienced in that artery only. Theek hai. Then what are the, again one of the effect is renal and retinal damage takes place due to the hypertension. हायपरटेन्शनमुळे अजून काय होतं की किडनी तर डॅमेज होतेच, पण त्यामुळे डोळ्याचा रेटिना डॅमेज होऊ शकतो, बिकॉज देर इज अ लो ब्लड सप्लाय, अ हार्ड ब्लड सप्लाय टू द रेटिना. इट इज वन ऑफ द मेन ऑर्गन ऑफ द आय. देन रिनल और रेटिनल डॅमेज मे टेक्स प्लेस ड्यू टू द हायपरटेन्शन. देन वॉट आर द कॉजेस ऑफ हाय बी पी और हायपरटेन्शन, काय कारणं असू शकतात ब्लड प्रेशर हाय होण्याचे. One of the main reason is also that there is a emotional stress. If there is a emotional stress, anxiety, more exercise, more exertion of work, it may result into hypertension. Then the cholesterol rich diet, fat rich diet or a lipid rich diet, telkat tupkat khana, he suddha high BP madhe result hoo shakta. It may result due to two main causes. हाय बी पीचे दोन महत्त्वाची कारणं असतात. एक तर आर्टेरियोस्क्लेरॉसिस, दॅट इज द रिडक्शन ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ आर्टरी ऑर हार्डनिंग ऑफ आर्टरी. आर्टरी नावाच्या ब्लड वेसल्स ह्या गच्च जाड रफ आणि टफ होतात, त्यांची लवचिकता कमी होते आणि त्यामुळे ब्लड सप्लाय, हृदयाला होणारा ब्लड सप्लाय हा काय होतो, कमी होतो. वेन देर इज अ रिडक्शन इन द इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ आर्टरी अँड when there is a hardening of artery, that process is called as arteriosclerosis. It may result into a high BP. Second one, atherosclerosis. What do you mean by atherosclerosis? In the lumen of artery, artery cha madhe ji pokal jaga hai, that artery, it is made up of three layer, that is the tunica adventitia or tunica externa, tunica media, and the inner one, tunica intima or tunica interna. When tunica intima, inside that tunica intima, a lumen is there. Inside that lumen, due to a fat-rich diet or due to any abnormal functioning of a liver and blood contents, that lipid content in that lumen is increases. It forms a plaque. ही ब्लड वेसल आहे, याच्यामध्ये अशा ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन तयार होतात, अडथळे तयार होतात. कशामुळे? फॅट रिच डायटमुळे किंवा ॲबनॉर्मल कोलेस्ट्रॉल फॉर्मेशनमुळे. वी आर हॅविंग द टू टाईप्स ऑफ कोलेस्ट्रॉल, इट इज वन ऑफ द टाईप ऑफ लिपिड. दॅट लिपिड, इट इज ऑफ टू टाईप, दॅट इज द हाय डेन्सिटी कोलेस्ट्रॉल अँड लो डेन्सिटी कोलेस्ट्रॉल. लो डेन्सिटी कोलेस्ट्रॉल, इट इज अ बॅड कोलेस्ट्रॉल विच इज हॅविंग लो डेन्सिटी, देअर फॉर इट मूव्ह थ्रू आउट द ब्लड वेसल अँड इट फॉर्म्स अ प्लेक्स. ते त्याच्याभोवती त्याचं एक गाठ तयार करत आहे आणि ते ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन्स, ते अडथळे ब्लड वेसल्समध्ये निर्माण होतात, आर्टरीमध्ये साचतात. High density cholesterol, HDL, it is the good one. And it is also formed by the liver, but it is formed in a low amount. And LDL, low density cholesterol, bad cholesterol, it is formed in more amount. High density cholesterol, it is not movable. It is remain as it is at one place, stable, stagnant in nature. That when there is a atherosclerosis, it forms a atherosclerotic plaques in the artery. That atherosclerosis means for that in the lumen of artery there is a presence of cholesterol rich substances, fats, lipids in that lumen of artery, and it may result into the obstruction to the blood flow. That arterio and atherosclerosis, it may causes the high BP. Then smoking. Smoking, it is also injurious to lungs, but it is also injurious to the heart again. Then alcoholism, drug addiction, that continuous taking of alcohol that result into the hypertension or high blood pressure. Then emotional stress, fatty diet, that lipid rich or cholesterol rich diet. Then increase in renin or ADH secretion. That high blood pressure, it is also transferred genetically from one generation to another generation. That one gene is responsible for that dysfunctioning of cardiac muscle, that is carried out to generation to generation. It is not expressed in all children, all offsprings, but it is that gene is present to the offsprings. When a person is having a myocardial infarction or a gene for the cholesterol rich formation plaques, then it is transferable. Then increase in renin and ADH secretion. Renin, it is one of the again hormone secreted by the it is one of the atrial natriuretic factor. It is secreted by the walls of atrium, and it having the greater effect on the blood pressure exerted on the nephrons. That again antidiuretic hormone ADH, it is also called as vasopressin, which is again secreted in the parturition time, baby's birth, but it is needed for the maintaining blood pressure, to maintain the glomerular filtration rate, to form the urine. And renin and ADH secretion, when it goes above the normal, it also result in the hypertension. When kidneys goes with the abnormal function, then there is a result in the increased secretion of renin and ADH secretion to force out the nephron to more work. And when there is a force on the nephron, it may result into the hypertension or high blood pressure. This is brief idea about the hypertension. Next disease or next heart disorder is CAD, or which is also called as coronary artery disease. It is one of the again main important disorders related with heart. It is also called as atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis, what is mean by atherosclerosis? It is the deposition of lipid or fatty substances in the artery lumen. Artery, TS of artery having the three layers, tunica externa or tunica adventitia, that tunica in that media, and third one tunica intima. Inside the tunica intima, a lumen is there. That lumen, it is small in case of artery, and it is large in case of a vein. When there is a deposition of lipids in the artery lumen, it decreases the diameter of the artery. And when there is a deposition of lipid substances, when your diet is rich with the fatty substances, when your digestion is improper, when you are having the genetic disorders with the cholesterol, then there is a deposition of fatty substances in the artery lumen. And if there is a deposition of fatty substances in the lumen of artery, think that if it is artery and there is a fatty substances deposited, and deposition of fatty substances make a covered area, that area it is called as atherosclerotic plaque, PLAQUE. That plaque, it is formed by the fatty substances, and due to this reduction in the diameter of artery, and if the diameter of artery it is get reduced, blood flow to the heart also get reduced. And it also exert more pressure on the walls of artery. Baga, chotesha jagetun blood la jayche, ekada liquid la fluid la flow vayche, tar te tya wall var kay karta, jast pressure exert karta. Thik hai? And if it forms plaques in, plaques kuthe form hotat? It forms plaques in a tunica intima, internal layer madhe. These plaques exceed to the tunica media also, smooth muscles parent pan he result hotat. And when there is a formation of plaques, he jadthale nirman hotat, ह्या ज्या रक्ताच्या गाठी निर्माण व्हायला लागतात, दॅट प्लेक्स फॉर्म अ स्मूथ मसल्स अँड फायबर्स अराउंड इट. वेन देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्मूथ मसल्स अँड फायबर्स अराउंड दॅट प्लेक, इट हॅविंग अ ब्लड सप्लाय अगेन. म्हणजे कुठलंही अडथळा निर्माण व्हायला लागला की त्याच्याभोवती रक्तवाहिन्या निर्माण होतात, मसल्स आणि फायबर्स निर्माण होतात, तिथे रक्तपुरवठा वाढवला जातो, आणि ॲक्च्युली लहानपणापासून वाढत आलेल्या हार्टवर अतिरिक्त ताण वाढतो. इट इज ऑल्सो इन द केस ऑफ डायबिटीज. एक आता पर्सन ओबेस आहे त्याला डायबिटीज आहे, इट गेट अ डिपॉझिशन ऑफ फॅटी सबस्टन्स ऑन द स्टमक. हार्ट तर जेवढं आहे तेवढंच राहील वयानुसार वाढलेलं, पण जेव्हा आपल्या शरीरावर मेद किंवा फॅट वाढतं तेव्हा ब्लड वेसल्स वाढतात. अतिरिक्त ब्लड वेसल वाढलं की ब्लडचा पुरवठा जास्त करावा लागतो, फोर्स जास्त एक्झर्ट करावा लागतो आणि यासाठी हृदयावर अतिरिक्त ताण वाढतो. इट मे रिझल्ट इन द हाय बी पी ऑर द करोनरी आर्टरी डिसीज. देन वॉट इज करोनरी आर्टरी? इट इज द मेन आर्टरी विच सप्लाईज ब्लड टू द ऑक्सिजनेटेड ब्लड टू द हार्ट अँड इट इज द ब्रांच ऑफ डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा. सिस्टमॅटिक एओर्टाच्या ब्रांचेस आहेत दॅट असेंडिंग एओर्टा, एओर्टिक आर्क अँड डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा. चढत जाणारी एओर्टा लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकलपासून, एओर्टिक आर्क म्हणजे एओर्टाचा एक सेमी सर्कल, आणि डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा करोनरी आर्टरी. इट इज द ब्रांच ऑफ अ डिसेंडिंग एओर्टा अँड वेन देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ प्लेक्स, इट इज हॅविंग अ रफ स्ट्रक्चर, इट हॅविंग प्लेटलेट ग्रोथ फॅक्टर अबो इट. देन अ ब्लड फ्लो, इट इज रिड्यूस्ड टू द ऑर्गन्स अँड एंटायर आर्टरी ब्लॉक्स. वेन देर इज अ रिडक्शन, वेन देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ प्लेक्स इन द ल्युमेन ऑफ आर्टरी, देन इट रिझल्ट इन टू द रिडक्शन ऑफ अ blood supply to the organs, to the heart and entire artery blocks itself. Sometime whole artery block, then the blockages, it is measured in terms of a percentage. 62% block hai, 92% block hai, 40% block hai. Every person when it having the fatty rich diet, हे फॅट वितळवणं खूप सारे एन्झाईमचं काम आहे. प्रत्येकाच्या शरीरात त्या एन्झाईमचं सिक्रेशन, फॅटी सबस्टन्सचं डिपॉझिशन वेगवेगळं असतं. कुणी खूप फॅटी सबस्टन्स खाऊन पण त्याला ब्लॉकेज होत नाही. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द बॉडी मेटाबॉलिझम. देन इट रिड्यूसेस विच कार्ड दॅट करोनरी आर्टरी डिसीज रिड्यूसेस द ब्लड सप्लाय ऑफ हार्ट. आणि हार्टला होणारा ब्लड सप्लाय जर कमी झाला, थांबला गेला, तर काय होतं? इट रिझल्ट इन टू हार्ट अटॅक. देर इज अ प्रोग्रेसिव्ह विकनिंग ऑफ अ कार्डियाक मसल्स अँड वेन progressive weakening takes place, sometime heart stops its function and it result with a pain in a lower jaw, left arm, left back side, left neck side and left ear and left behind cheek area. That pain in all that organ, it is diagnosed as a heart attack or myocardial infarction. In that condition, heart suffers from a low blood supply, weakening of cardiac muscles, low oxygen supply. And that condition, it is called as MI or myocardial infarction or heart attack. This is about the CAD and we are also know about the angina pectoris. And one of the fourth disease or disorder, not a disease, it is the disorder that is the sudden heart failure. It is the sudden stoppage of a heart functioning. Due to the progressive weakening of a coronary artery, due to the progressive weakening of cardiac muscle, due to the low blood or oxygen supply to the heart muscles, then it result into the sudden inhibition of cardiac muscle or sudden stoppage of the cardiac muscle or sudden stoppage of the heart functioning. It is called as a heart failure and it may result into the progressive that smoking, alcoholism, emotional stress, atherosclerosis, arteriosclerosis, then abnormal functioning of a hormone, abnormal secretion of hormone, that is the heart failure, which is also called as a MI. Then it is the brief idea about the hypertension and coronary artery disease. These are the blood related or heart related disorders. This is all for today. Thank you, student, for today's video.